Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, for those who don't know me, my name is Andrew Barr. I'm acting principal at Harris City Academy Crystal Palace. And I'd like to extend my very warm welcome to you all for coming on such a cold evening and supporting our students who are going to give us some fantastic performances tonight. So I hope to hear a lot of applause for them after they've done that, because it is an exceedingly nerve-wracking task for a lot of them, and but they're going to do us proud, and they're really fantastic, and they've been practicing for many weeks. So without further ado, I'd just like to hand over to our Year 7 choir, who are going to do something with, what is it, Jingle Bells?
Yes.
Jingle Bells, very exciting. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
quite a good toast I'd normally like to be. You have come on a rather special night, and we are all rushing around. But it's quite good, because you see something rather spectacular. I have to be somewhere else right now. Where am I going? Let my assistants explain it to you.
What you are going to see tonight really started many years ago. When people decided to do things that displeased God, God needed a plan to rescue the situation. His plan was very simple. He would send his son Jesus down to earth as a man to Israel to teach the people how they should live.
But that is only part of the plan. The main part is that Jesus will die in place of the punishment everyone deserves. That way God can forgive anyone who wants to follow God. Simple, really, but very clever and very full. And tonight is when the plan starts to operate, because Jesus is going to be born.
Tell them this has happened, and we can do anything here. We can take you back in time. Come on, let me show you how we used to visit the prophets and tell them about the plan. We were so excited that we used to visit them and tell them what was going to happen.
Sometimes I think we used to tell them a lot more than we were supposed to. Actually, we told them everything. Bethlehem, the Virgin, riding on a donkey, 30 pieces of silver, dying for our sins, in short, everything. Look over there, you can see an angel telling the prophet Isaiah about tonight, and that happened 600 years ago.
Isaiah, I have a message for you to proclaim to the people.
The people walking in the darkness have seen a great light. For us, a child has been born. To us, a son has been given. He will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. He will reign on David's throne and uphold it with justice and righteousness. Then you will say, give thanks to the Lord, sing to the Lord, for he has done glorious things.
I have many other messages for you about a time in the future when God will save his people. Times about joy and not sadness, of hope and not fear. Look around and you'll see evil kings, wars, fighting, people cheating in the marketplace. But a time will come when God will save his people. And it'll start with the baby you have just read about.
Thank you.
Things really started to get hot about 9 months ago. Gabriel, tell us about it.
First, I visited Mary and told her that she would have a baby called Jesus and that this baby would be the Son of God. It was a bit of a shock to Mary, but she was so pleased that she'd been chosen by God to be the mother of Jesus. Then I had to speak to Joseph. He was engaged to marry Mary, but was so confused to learn that she was expecting a baby that he even thought about cancelling the wedding. I explained to Joseph that this was a special baby and that he should take care of Mary. Joseph, he's a good man, and I'm glad that we chose him to be the father of Jesus.
You're right. They'll be very good parents. We should have that soon after the wedding, when baby Jesus is sure to be born.
But the trouble is, they can't stay in their homes in Nazareth. The Romans want people to return to the towns of their ancestors to sort out things like taxes. And so today, Mary and Joseph are travelling to Bethlehem. Jesus will be born in Bethlehem, and it is our job to make sure that everything goes well.
Hello? Seriously, that's great news. I'll tell them now. Apparently, Mary and Joseph have just been spotted approaching Bethlehem. I'm sorry, we're needed elsewhere. please. You just wait. We're going to put on a fantastic light show for some shepherds tonight.
Thank you. business. We're going to earn a great bonus by the end of the year.
Hello again. This is the inn that Mary and Joseph were supposed to stay, but there's been a small hiccup. We were supposed to make sure that one of the rooms was left empty for them, but someone seemed to slip in when we weren't watching.
We should have got Mary and Joseph to leave earlier.
Well, we tried, but Mary wanted to check that the doors were locked, to check that the fire had been switched off, to check that the lamps were switched off, etc. But there is some space around the back. Not ideal, but it will have to do. And Gabriel did say that we'd come in humble surroundings. You can't get much more humble than that stable.
You watch this, no one down there can see me.
Hello, you who?
Someone has to go at the door. I thought you said we were all full.
We are. I shall send them away.
Looks like trouble. She's expecting a baby.
Well, we have no room. I have an idea. They can stay round the back. Not great, but it ought to be warm enough. Tree. Look over there, there are shepherds, and keep an eye on what's going on.
Yeah. Don't be afraid. I have good news for you. Over in Bethlehem, a baby has been born. He is Christ the Lord, and he will be the saving of his people. Go, quick, and you'll see him.
Come on.
Quick.
Come on.
Okay, let me explain what's happening now. Some time ago, we sent a star over the east, and some clever kings realized that we were sending them a message about the birth of Jesus. So they set off, following the star as we wanted. But they got lost. Lost? Can you imagine it? They only had to follow the star. And what's worse, they called in on King Herod to ask the way. King Herod, I ask you, that bloke is pure evil. And you can bet he won't sit still and do nothing now. So we better act quick. Okay, guys, we have a problem.
Yes, we've heard.
I'm going over to Jerusalem and we'll get Herod's advisors to point the king towards Jerusalem.
And once the king has visited Jesus, I will tell him that Jesus wants to go back to Jerusalem, but so quickly he was
there. And then why would you want Joseph to take his family to Egypt?
But don't Mary and Joseph have to take Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem a few days after he's been born?
That's okay. There's time on our side. King Herod won't have any act together like that. Remember, he won't know what.
Okay, sounds good to me. You guys think of everything.
Thank you.
very first Christmas. For a little while, we will stay excited.
Finally, God has come into the world in the form of a human, as a little baby.
But later on, things will get very sad and painful. And when the baby Jesus will have grown up to be a man, the authorities will kill him on the cross.
But that is all part of the plan, so that God can save his people.
But now we have more work to do.
We have to get Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus out of Bethlehem and off to Egypt safely.
And an angel's work is never done.